In the last 30 days, we generated over 150,000 website visitors through SEO. That's insane. Even crazier, in the last 2 years, we generated over 4 million visitors from Google alone. That's not even counting the traffic from other search engines like Yahoo, Bing, and YouTube. SEO is one of the best ways to increase traffic to your website. But what is SEO? Like, what does SEO really mean? And how does SEO work? Unfortunately, when I talk about SEO to some of our clients, their confused responses make me feel like I'm talking a foreign language. A lot of people think that SEO is just too complicated. So instead of trying to get a hang of it to grow their business exponentially at low cost, they jump into the rat race of more traditional forms of advertising, where the big businesses who can afford to spend the most ultimately win. But what if I told you that SEO wasn't so complicated? What if I told you that SEO was really, in fact, quite simple, but it's just a technical jargon that really intimidates people? If you're intrigued by this, buckle up, because today we're breaking SEO all the way down. Hi, my name is Sherman with Life Marketing, a digital marketing agency that helps small businesses grow. Today, I'm going to fully define SEO, tell you why it's a must for any business, why most people fail at SEO, and give you my top tips to get started. Let me start off with a small case study of how all of this works. A few years ago, a really cool snow bike manufacturer came to me and wanted some help increasing their e-commerce sales. They spent so much money in advertising trying to push people to their website. So I told them, you're doing a lot to generate traffic already, but what are you doing about the people who are already looking for you? I mean, there has to be people in the market for this type of stuff already, right? What are you doing about that? Flabbergasted by what I was saying, they were dying to know more. And that's how the topic of SEO came up. Fast forward 1 year later, they obtained top Google positions, generated a ton of free traffic, and most importantly, made over $100,000 in revenue from the SEO campaign. Now they're flourishing with more business than they ever could have imagined. And I want the same for you. So now, let's break down SEO to its roots and equip you with the tactics you need in order to grow your business. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe to our channel if you want more step-by-step marketing strategies to help you grow your business. And if you receive any value from this video, please help me out by clicking the like button below. Now, let's really begin. So what is SEO? SEO stands for Search Engine Optimization. It refers to the process of optimizing your website to get organic and free traffic from the search engine results pages. For example, let's say you're searching for accounting services for your business. If you search small business accounting services, this is what shows up. There are some ads that appear at the top of the search result page, and then you'll see some local SEO results followed by some organic SEO listing. Now, the ads at the very top are businesses who are paying Google directly to provide immediate exposure to their business. These are the people who are literally paying for every click that they get to their websites. And depending on the industry, they can pay upwards to $10, $20, $50, even $100 for a single click. Now, I don't deny that Google Ads can be effective, but you have to know your numbers or your costs can just spiral right out of control. SEO, on the other hand, is completely free. Once you're ranking, you're paying absolutely nothing to receive clicks from search engines. In fact, they choose to rank your website because it helps them provide value to their users. Just think about it. Why do you use Google? You most likely use it to find answers to your questions and solutions to your problems. That's a given, right? But why do you use Google over Yahoo, Bing, AOL, and all those other sites? It's likely because Google provides better answers and solutions to your problems and questions. And believe it or not, if you focus on providing the best answers and solutions to search queries related to your business, then you're very likely to succeed at SEO for your business. In fact, it's Google's mission to organize all the information in the world and make it accessible and useful. So if you want to rank above your competitors on Google, your site's content needs to be accessible and useful. Now, the trick is that those words accessible and useful are very subjective and are ultimately determined by Google's algorithm. And that's the trickiest part about SEO. Google has not and likely will not disclose their algorithm fully to the public for obvious reasons. With that said, it's believed that there are over 200 ranking factors that they use to rank websites. Luckily, there has already been tons of independent studies on the top ranking websites on Google, and thousands of practitioners have successfully optimized websites to rank highly on Google. But before we dive into all of that, let's quickly discuss a more important topic. Why is SEO important for every business? There are endless benefits of SEO, but no one can deny these major reasons why every business needs to utilize SEO. Number one, your customers are searching for business solutions on Google. When your customers need to find a solution to a problem, 9 times out of 10, they will start their search on Google. Whether they're looking for a plumber, landscaper, accountant, new software, and so on, they're likely going to start their search on Google. Therefore, if your business cannot be found on Google, not only are you missing out on free traffic, but you're also missing out on hot leads. The truth is, there are over 5 billion searches on Google every single day and over 3 million searches every single minute. If you think there are not people looking for your solution on Google, I have to tell you, you're wrong. Even if you're coming out with the next big thing, there are still likely people searching for information around the problems your innovative solution solves. Now let's move on. Number two, SEO traffic is more likely to convert than other traffic sources. Who do you think is more likely to buy from you? Someone who impulsively clicked on your ad, or someone who is actively searching for a business like yours? More times than not, the person who is actively in the market searching for solutions is more likely to pull the trigger on a big purchase faster than someone who is curious to learn more about your business after seeing an ad. In fact, small businesses are currently reporting an 8 times higher conversion rate from SEO traffic than they are from other traffic sources like direct mail and print advertising. If you want high conversion rates from your digital marketing efforts, SEO should be at the top of your list. Number three, SEO will decrease your customer acquisition costs. In the game of digital advertising, everything is about things like return on ad spend or just trying to figure out if your campaign is profitable or not. This financial stress is not present with SEO investments, primarily because the traffic is free and that traffic compounds. As we discussed, once you rank at the top of Google, you're virtually getting free traffic from search engines, and that traffic compounds. So you're not just reaching people searching for your business today, like you would with an ad, but you're reaching people for weeks, months, and sometimes years. For example, some of the top performing blogs on our own website has resulted in hundreds of thousands of website visitors. Imagine investing $500 into a piece of content that returned 250,000 website visitors over a 2-year period. I did the math on that, and that's literally less than a penny per click to your website. Or for you math nerds like me out there, that's exactly 0.002 cents per website visitor. What's even crazier is that these blogs are still driving traffic to our website today. Who's to say how much traffic we'll get in the next 12 months, 5 years, and so on? It's gotten to the point where I seriously don't even keep track of the ROI of our SEO efforts in terms of dollars and cents. I care more about if our content is actually ranking and generating traffic. If it is, then I already know the rest is going to take care of itself. Okay, you might be thinking, this sounds too good to be true. There has to be some type of catch to all this, right? As much as I'd like to say no, there's no catch to this, and it is too good to be true. The fact of the matter is, there is one big roadblock that stops most people from becoming successful at SEO. And this thing is the single reason why a lot of people I talk to decline to invest into SEO. And it's quite sad, to be honest with you. The biggest reason why people choose not to invest into SEO is because SEO takes at least 6 to 12 months to be effective. Let that soak in for a second. This means you won't see results tomorrow, next week, next month, or even next quarter. And unfortunately, this single fact runs people away. They literally run away from free traffic, ready-to-go leads, and the lowest customer acquisition cost available on the internet. The reason why it takes months for SEO to work is because it literally takes time to set up your website correctly for SEO and to start sending the appropriate user signals to Google so they can identify your website as useful to their search engines. As much as I like to sell SEO as some get a six pack in 30 days program, the truth is SEO isn't that type of program. And we know those get fit quick programs are complete scams anyway, and that it typically takes 6 to 12 months of good eating and exercise to get that six pack, right? Either way, look, here's the truth. It takes the right strategy, discipline, and patience to be successful at SEO. And if I had to be brutally honest with you, these are the traits you need to be successful at almost anything you do in your business. The alternative to long-term strategies like SEO is to join the rat race of advertisers who are competing to spend the most to acquire customers. As competition rises and cost per clicks rise, you're going to have to increase your prices to afford those higher acquisition costs, or drop out of the rat race altogether. You can only increase your prices so much before it's more expensive than the market is willing to pay. Or to put it to you this way, once you stop your advertising campaign, your business is basically out of business. Because once that ad stops running, all that momentum comes to an end. Don't get me wrong, these strategies are great for the short term, but if you're in business for the long haul, you need to invest into long-term strategies like SEO as soon as you can, so you can reap those benefits faster. 12 months will fly by and you will either be in a better position than you are today or in the same position. It's your choice. But let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you think SEO is a good investment for your business? Let me know and let's talk about it. Okay, if you reached this point of the video, then you're probably considering taking your website's SEO to the next level. So let me give you the keys to start climbing those search engines. First, determine the keywords you want to rank for. The very first step in SEO is to determine the keywords you want to rank for on Google. Now you should choose your keywords based on the words relevance to your business, volume, and its competitiveness. Relevant words are simply words that are related to your products or services. If you're ranking for words that drive traffic to your website, but does not motivate people to purchase your product or services, you'll end up with a bunch of traffic and no results. So choose your keywords carefully based off of buyer's intent. You also should make sure that the words you wish to rank for are actually being searched for on Google. You can simply use a tool like Google Keyword Planner to look at your search volume and competitiveness. The second thing you need to do is to help Google understand your website. This process is called on-page SEO. In short, you need to tell Google that you have the answers to the keywords people are searching for. You can do this by adding keywords to your website's title, description, content, image tags, and Google tags. Or in more technical terms, you need to optimize your meta tags, title tags, headers, image alt tags, etc. The third thing you need to do is to help Google trust your website. Just because Google understands your website doesn't mean they trust you. For example, they can fully interpret your website and place you on page 99. And because 99% of people don't click past page 1 of the search results, you're probably not going to get any traffic once your site is indexed. To push your website up the search engines, you're going to have to demonstrate that your website is trustworthy. The last thing Google wants to do is to send their users to bad websites. And the newer the website is, the more work you're going to have to do to earn their trust. In the SEO industry, we measure this trust score with a metric called domain authority. The higher the authority of your website, the more likely you are to rank once Google indexes your website. To improve your domain authority, you need to produce signals that show that your website is useful to users. The simplest way to do this is to provide a great user experience. Make sure that your website is easy to navigate, loads quickly, and above all else, is valuable to the user. Google looks at website metrics like click-through rate, time on site, bounce rate, and so on to determine if your website is useful to the user. Another major way to improve your domain authority is through backlinks. Backlinks are simply links on an external website that points to your domain. For example, in this blog post, this hyperlink would be considered a backlink. The more backlinks you receive from credible websites that Google trusts, the more Google will trust your website. Think of backlinks as a letter of recommendation from that website to Google. Google picks up on these signals to rank websites in their search results. Ultimately, once Google understands and trusts your website is when you will start to move up the search engine. To best accomplish this, you're going to have to understand the SEO algorithm in and out. So make sure you subscribe to our channel right now so you don't miss our future breakdown on the SEO algorithm, as well as some other content that we're putting out to help you grow your business. Now, let's summarize this video so you can get to work. We talked about what is SEO. SEO, which stands for search engine optimization, is the process of optimizing your website to get organic, free traffic from the search engine result pages. Why is SEO so important? SEO is so important because your customers literally rely on it to find business solutions and answers to their questions. Traffic from SEO is more likely to convert, and SEO can dramatically lower your customer acquisition cost over time. Then we discussed the biggest obstacle of SEO, time. In order to succeed at SEO, you have to adapt the right strategy, have discipline, and exercise patience. Then over time, you can enjoy the compound effects of SEO traffic. Finally, we discussed the steps to implement a successful SEO campaign. In short, you have to help Google understand your website and trust your website. You can do this through on-page and off-page SEO. Anyway, let me know what you think about all of this in the comments below. And if you have any further questions, feel free to drop them in the comments and I'll try my best to answer them. That's it for today, folks. Talk to you soon.